Okay, stand by. Here we go.
There's no business like show business, like no business I know.
Everything about it is appealing.
Everything the traffic will allow.
Nowhere could you get that happy feeling when you are stealing that extra bow. There's no people like show people. They smile when they are low. Even with a turkey that you know will fold, you may be stranded out in the cold, but still you wouldn't change it for a sack of gold. Let's go on with our show.
Gentlemen, welcome to the Muppets, a celebration of 30 years. They've come from all over, converging on this glittering ballroom. And now, here they are at last, all of Jim Henson's Muppets, except for those who couldn't make it. And now, to get things started, here he is, the one and only Fozzie Bear.
Hey, waka. Yes, I know it's hard to believe, but the Muppets are 30 years old.
That's okay with me. I love being 30.
You old fool, your pacemaker's older than that.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, and pigs and bears and things and stuff. Here he is, our guest of honor, Kermit the Frog!
Thank you very much.
We come together tonight to pay tribute to our beloved flippered friend.
Oh, come on, Fozzie.
No, Kermit, you deserve it. I mean, you're the one who started it all.
Everyone remembers how you brought us to Hollywood to fulfill our dream.
Miss Tracy. Prepare the standard rich and famous contract for Kermit the Frog and Company.
But few people remember your humble beginnings back in the mid-50s. It was a local TV show in Washington, D.C. called Sam and Friends.
I should stay away, but what can I do? I hear your name and I'm aflame. And only a kiss.
Put out the fire. Hey, what are you doing?
Oh, I'm taking a course in visual thinking. It teaches you how to visualize your thoughts. Watch. Cue. See that?
Man, you're just a beginner. I'm an old hand at this stuff. Watch.
Hey, a real watch.
With moving parts, no less.
I've grown accustomed to your looks. Accustomed to your voice.
Okay, buddy, what do you think of Wilkins coffee?
I never tasted it.
Now, what do you think of Wilkins?
A toy chow mein is quick cooked by me in Dragon Fire. And remember, you heard about it from the LaJoy Dragons!
I didn't know we did commercials.
Oh, yeah. Hey, did you know that Rolf was the first Muppet to have a regular spot on network television? Back in 1963 with Jimmy Dean.
Really?
I used to be a big star back then.
This spray is guaranteed to soothe throat irritation. It will also relieve infection of tissues and is extremely effective in severe cases of laryngitis. For best results, use at room temperature and spray gently over the entire throat. What the heck happened?
My belly button blew up.
The youngsters have been sending in loads of mail asking me when we plan to have the Muppets back on our show. Well, I don't know exactly, so here they are now. The Muppets!
What did you have in mind?
Well, I thought we could
go with you to the hop.
And finally, the ultimate achievement.
From Hollywood, The Tonight Show, starring Johnny Carson. Johnny's guest host tonight is Kermit the Frog.
The Muppets and I just love coming to Hollywood. You know, this is the first time, and we're just like any tourists. Today, we all went to Disneyland. You know, Miss Piggy, Fozzie, and myself. The guard at the gate didn't want to let us out. You know, it looks sort of silly to see all those people running around dressed like, a mouse and a duck.
Louder and funnier.
I'm doing my best out here.
You're dying.
Of course he was dying. Never send a frog to do a pig's job.
And now, here are the stars of that first local TV show, Sam and Friends.
Hey, I just have one question, man. How come you look so much better now than you did then?
Well, that's one of the advantages of being a Muppet. By the way, where is Yorick? Oh. Oh, you're it, yes. Anyway, let's remember all the help that I've had through the years.
In the early days, Kermit got a lot of help from Sam and Friends. And then the Muppet Show came along, and he got a lot of help from us guys.
I got rhythm.
Oh, gotcha. I got rhythm. I got.
No. Fozzie, hold on. Let me make one little change. Okay,
I don't got rhythm. I don't got rhythm. I don't got rhythm.
Who could ask for anything more?
We could.
Yeah. Who could ask for anything more?
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. This evening, I will perform a feat of lunatic daring. Before your very eyes, I will ride this motorcycle up this ramp and jump directly into that box, landing safely between those two elderly gentlemen.
What?
On my mark. Get set. Go.
Hooray! Bravo! Wonderful! Encore!
And so here he is now, ladies and gentlemen.
I'm ready, Kermit!
Yeah, I'm introducing you.
Introduce fast, I'm really ready.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, the great Gonzo!
Kermit the Frog's co-stars, there is one lady we cannot forget. She is one of the biggies, no matter how tight we lace her corset. Little joke there, Piggy. Anyhow, ladies and gentlemen, as we have seen over the years, no one can make an entrance like our own Miss Piggy. Once again, the fantastic Miss Piggy. It's an astronomical event.
Yeah. A falling star!
Knock it off! Just as we rehearsed it.
Piggy, are you okay?
Oh, Cammy! Oh, my love and mon amour! Oh, happy 30th birthday, dear.
Well, thank you, Miss Piggy, but remember, it isn't just my birthday, it's ours.
Cammy, dear. By no bizarre stretch of the imagination, dear, could it ever be moi's 30th birthday, huh?
Oh, yeah, of course. You joined us very recently.
As a child star.
Yeah, sure she did.
And so we have seen how far Kermit has come, from local television show host to happily married frog.
Piggy. Listen, we're supposed to be introducing scenes from our movies.
And you've done it tray well, hubby.
There'll be spectacle, there'll be fantasy, there'll be daring do and stuff like you would never see.
Hey, a movie!
Yeah, we're gonna be a movie!
Starring everybody!
And me! There'll be heroes, balls, there'll be comedy, and a lot of fuss that ends for us real happily.
Hey, a movie!
We can watch it all develop!
Starring everybody!
And me!
There'll be mystery!
But it's all in fun, you pay the money, wait and see.
Hey,
Don't forget my favorite movie scene, the bicycles. Everybody's always asking how we did that.
Get that fish out of my face.
Why couldn't we fly?
I know we get
by. Couldn't we fly?
We fly.
We fly.
We fly.
We fly.
We
fly.
Sunny sky.
Ready day.
Just a bush. And we're on the way. Yes, couldn't we ride?
Couldn't we ride?
Hey guys, how did they do that?
Still to come, Sesame Street and a galaxy of guest stars with the Muppets.
Thank you. Thank you. And so, we have seen the rise of our web-footed friend from the early days to his superstardom in Hollywood.
The Muppets are seen on television in 150 countries and on film, books, and records everywhere.
Yes, Kermit is truly an institution.
He's truly a frog, Fozzie. A frog. Let's not get carried away.
Sorry. Moving right along.
I object!
Pardon?
You didn't show my favorite part.
What part is that?
Well, in the old days, everything the Muppets did had monsters in it.
Yeah. Well, what did you go with that?
It is whatever. That's what I said. And everything ended with eating. An explosion!
Yeah.
We're ugly as sin. But beautiful's out, ugly's in. If you're ugly like me, you're in good company. There are millions of us who are ugly. There are millions of us who are ugly.
Sesame Street equals two friends from Sesame Street. Bert and Ernie.
Thank you, Count. We of Sesame Street are proud to have been a part of the educational and cultural life of America for all these many years. The fact that Muppets can work for increased educational opportunities...
Hey, Bert.
...causes one...
Your nose is loose, Bert.
I think that is not funny.
Oh, but that's the old nose joke, Bert. It's been funny ever since Sesame Street started back in 1969.
That's true. You have been doing that to me for 17 years.
I know, Bert. But don't thank me. It's my job.
Sesame Street.
Q R Cookie Monster.
monster isn't a letter of the alphabet. It goes Q-R-S-T-U-V. Next time, Cookie Monster can do it with you. I'm leaving.
I love you.
I love you, too.
Thanks.
Your move, Bernice. Your move.
You're teaching a pigeon to play checkers?
Mm-hmm.
Why, that's amazing. That's the most incredible thing I've ever heard of.
Oh, and it's no big deal.
No big deal? Mm-hmm. Why, a pigeon that can play checkers, that must be the smartest pigeon in the whole world.
Well, she's really not that smart, Ernie.
Not that smart, Bert? Mm-hmm. How can you say that?
Well, in the 10 games we've played, mm-hmm. she's only beaten me twice.
C is for Cookie, that's good enough for me. Yeah, C is for Cookie, that's good enough for me. C is for Cookie, that's good enough for me. Oh, Cookie starts with C. Yeah, Cookie starts with C.
You know me, I spend a lot of time on one street. But once in a while, I want to go somewhere else, and I have to cross the street to do it. But, like you, I'm not old enough to cross the street by myself. So that's why I use a grown-up friend's hand. A grown-up friend's hand. Don't cross the street without it.
This is Oscar the Grouch, so listen up. I didn't want to be here tonight, and now that I'm here, I can hardly wait to leave. Wait, I suppose I might as well introduce the giant overgrown bag of giblets. Or is he a turkey? All right, here he is now, Sesame Street's own Big Bird.
Oh, thank you, Oscar. Well, it's wonderful to be here at the Muppets' birthday party. But where's the cake?
Just do your speech, Featherface.
Well, the cake must be missing. Try not to panic. I just want to say that the Muppets have done all sorts of things for kids. First, there was Sesame Street. And now, there's Muppet Babies, Little Muppet Monsters, and Fraggle Rock, too.
On your brain.
Wow!
You know what this means, don't you?
Well, sure. It means what does it mean?
We can do our own TV show.
We can?
Little Muppet Monsters. Little Muppet Monsters. Little Muppet Monsters.
Fraggles are a noble race. Fearless, dignified, intellectual. They represent the very pinnacle of civilization and culture. Fraggles naturally have physical prowess and a dance-like grace.
Oh, a splendid team, but don't get big trouble here for me.
He says it is now time for a moving tribute to Kermit.
Young Uncle, this Fraggle thing is going to be...
Brought to you by the ever-popular Talking Food.
I don't know how many of you realize how difficult it is for vegetables to break into show business.
Yeah, when we first started out, the audience used to throw people at us.
Yeah, but the Muppets changed all that. Kermit was the first to recognize that we vegetables have talent. We're not just part of a balanced diet.
Kermit is interested in everyone and everything, no matter how strange.
This is Kermit the Frog speaking to you from the planet Coosbane. There's a hush in the air. This is the traditional time of courtship of the Coosbanian creatures. We're waiting now for the male Coosbanian creature to make the first move. Hark, that may be him now. Now that is the wonk-wonk signal to the female creature. Let's see if she makes the traditional response. Yeah, that is the traditional response to the wonk. There she is, and what a beauty. They're going to do the Galio hoop hoop. This should be very exciting. It's a television first, ladies and gentlemen, the Coosbanian Galio hoop hoop.
Galio!
There you have it, friends. Once again, love comes to Coosbane.
Do you know what it takes to be a Muppet?
Cookie!
No, imagination.
Come with me. And you'll be in a world of pure imagination. Take a look and you'll see into your imagination. We'll begin with a spin, traveling in a world of my creation. What we'll see will defy explanation. If you want to view paradise, simply look around and view it. Anything you want, do it. Wanna change the world? There's nothing to it. There is no life I know to compare to pure imagination. Living there, you'll be free if you truly wish to be. There is no life I know to compare with pure imagination. Living there, you'll be free if you truly wish to be. Come with me.
Next, great moments with Muppet guest stars and more highlights from the Muppets 30 years.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, Floyd and Janice.
Floyd and I would like to talk about Muppet music.
Through the years, some of our greatest fans have come from the hip world of jazz musicians.
Really? But that's only natural, isn't it?
Yeah, so how do you figure that our first big hit was Ernie singing Rubber Ducky?
Rubber Ducky, you're the one. You make bath time lots of fun. Rubber ducky, I'm awfully fond of you.
Phenomena. Phenomena. Phenomena.
Phenomena.
hopping and a-singing his song. All the little birds on Jaybird Street love to hear the robin go.
Tweet, tweet, tweet.
Rockin' Robin.
Tweet, tweet, tweet.
Rockin' Robin.
Tweet, twillity.
Blue Rockin' Robin, cause we're really gonna rock tonight.
Tweet, twillity.
Love that number.
Tweet, tweet, tweet.
You know my favorite thing about the world of the Muppets? The guest stars.
Steve Martin. Oh, Steve Martin. 15 seconds till curtain, Mr. Martin.
Thank you, Scooter. I'm almost ready.
See, you're going to feel right at home around here.
On the top. You're the top. You're the Louvre Museum. You're a melody of a symphony by Strauss.
You're a Mandelbaum of a Shakespeare sonnet.
You're Mickey Mouse.
Is that a compliment?
Well, you called me a Colosseum.
Sorry about that.
This program is trivial and not fit for family viewing. It is disgracefully lacking in culture.
It is disgracefully lacking in culture.
I'm glad you agree with me, yes. I personally have always felt that this program...
Reach out and touch somebody's hand and make this world a better place if you can. Reach out and touch somebody's hand and make
Gloria, I'm Kermit the Frog.
Well, hoppa, hoppa, you are some kind of cute stuff, fly boy.
Yeah.
I'm pleased to meet you.
Oh, well, I'm pleased to meet you too, Gloria. Hey, listen, I have a mission to fly, but when I get back, maybe I could buy you a root beer.
Well, I'd love it. We could play the jukebox and cut a rug.
Seconds to curtain, Mr. Burns.
I'm ready. But what is that?
It's my new act, Gonzo Fiddles While George Burns.
I like that joke. It's a pleasure to hear something that's older than I am.
That's depressing. We're older than that joke.
Uncle Kermit, what's your favorite thing about the Muppets?
Well, you know, Robin, there are times when the Muppets aren't funny.
Yeah, but I always figure that's the writer's fault.
Well, no, I'm really talking about those times when we don't try to be just funny.
Oh.
And I think maybe those are my favorite parts.
We're here for a very, very short time. And in that time that we're here, there really isn't any difference in any of us. If you were to take time out to understand each other. And the question is, do I know who you are? Do you know who I am? We care about each other, because if we do, together we can turn the world around.
We come from the fire, living in the fire. Go back to the fire, turn the world around.
We come from the fire, go back to the fire, turn the world around.
We come from the fire, living in the fire. Go back to the fire, turn the world around.
Water make the river, river wash the mountain. Fire make the sunlight, turn the world around.
Heart is of the river, body is the mountain. Spirit is the sunlight, turn the world around.
There's something happening here. What it is ain't exactly clear. There's a man with a gun over there telling me I've
got to beware. It's time we stop, children.
What's that sound? Everybody look what's going round. Stop,
children.
What's that sound? Everybody look what's going round.
It's not easy being green. It seems you blend in with so many other ordinary things. And people tend to pass you over because you're not standing out like flashy sparkles in the water or stars in the sky. But green's the color of spring. And green can be cool and friendly like.
You know? Never know what you mean.
Green can be big like an ocean. Important like a mountain.
That's right.
A tall like a tree.
It could make you wonder why, but why wonder,
I'm green, and it'll do fine, cause it's beautiful,
yes, it's beautiful,
and I think it's what I wanna be.
The Muppets give Kermit a special tribute.
Greetings, culture and poultry lovers. I have forsaken the rarefied ambiance of the head table to be down here with my girls.
Hello, Camilla, baby.
You're Camilla? I can never tell. All your chickens look alike. Now, girls, whoa, girls, stop it. Now, the time has come for me to speak of the seriously cultural side of the Muppets.
Last night we said a great many things. You said I was to do the thinking for both of us. Well, I've done a lot of it since then, and it adds up to just one thing. You're getting on that plane with Victor, where you belong. If that plane leaves the ground and you're not on it, you'll regret it. Maybe not today, maybe not tomorrow, but soon, and for the rest of your life. Look, I'm not good at being mobile, but it doesn't take much to see that the problems of three little people want to amount to a hill of beans in this crazy world. Someday you'll understand that. Here's looking for you, kid.
The Muppet News Flash. A charter flight carrying the London Symphony Orchestra has been forced to jettison some of the musical instruments.
Tell us, who has breached our security? Who is outside of our door?
Darth Nader.
Who are you behind that mask?
And well, you might ask.
Ah, good grief.
Now this Muppet News Flash. On Wall Street today, commodity experts were amazed as beef fell dramatically. Oh, no.
When a man's an empty kettle, he should be on his mettle. And yet I'm torn apart.
Just because I'm presuming that I could be kind of human if I only had a heart.
I'm afraid there's no denying I'm just a dandelion, a fate I don't deserve. I'd be brave as a blizzard,
I'd be gentle as a lizard,
I'd be clever as a gizzard,
if the wizard is a wizard, who will serve?
So we're off to see the wizard,
the wonderful wizard, the wonderful wizard, the wonderful wizard,
the wonderful wizard,
the wonderful wizard of Oz.
Excuse me, everybody. Now it is my turn to say something very, very special about our wonderful frog here.
Fozzie, let's not get mushy.
Oh, frog of my heart, is it mushy to say thank you for the faith that you have had in us all? Is it mushy to say thank you for making us a success in the show business, for all the hours of joy you have brought to the world?
Fozzie...
He's right, you know, Kermit.
Yeah, listen to the bear, my frog.
And so, Kermit, I just want to say that I can't go on with the role of film.
So many songs about rainbows.
That's part of what rainbows do.
Rainbows are memories,
sweet dream reminders. What is it you'd like to do?
All of us watching and wishing we'd find it.
Find them, you're watching.
Someday you'll find it, the rainbow connection. The loggers, the dreamer than you. Why are there so many songs about rainbows?
And what's on the
visions, but only illusions.
write your own ending.
Keep believing, keep pretending, we've done just what we set out to do.
Thanks, everybody. It's been a great birthday party. We start our second 30 years tomorrow, so rehearsal begins at 9 a.m. sharp. I'll see you then.
Happy feet. I've got those happy feet. Give them a low-down beat, and they begin dancing. I've got those 10 little tapping toes, and when they hear a tune, I can't control my dancing heels to save my soul. Weary blues can't get into my shoes, because my shoes refuse to ever grow weary. I keep cheerful on and cheerful of music sweet, because I've got happy feet.